I think it's important because it helps us to remember where we came from. So it reminds us who we are, and then allows us to determine where we're going to be going to. So in this particular year of 100 years of jazz, Jazz at Lincoln Center has dedicated itself to programming that addresses different decades. And Marcus is really modest, but he wrote a great piece on the 1930s, the swing era.
And Victor is modest, and he wrote a great piece from the 1920s as well.
Of the jazz age.
It's called Untamed Elegance.
Yeah, and yours is called Swing?
The Forever Swing Suite.
So Vincent Gardner wrote one about bebop, and he selected music on the bebop era. Chris Crenshaw has one coming up about the 1960s. And then I'm not sure about the other programs that's coming up, but Sherman Irby had one based upon the holiday music. So it's an opportunity for us to resurrect things that have been in cabinets and cellars and basements and things that people have forgotten about or didn't know about. For me, it's so important because, and I think this is true for every musician, when I think about jazz music, I think about the millions of people who were involved in this music before me, who were great musicians and great educators and great participants inside of the music in different ways, a job situation, but they were not documented. And for me in my life, it's been important to be a part of the documentation of jazz so that whenever my time on earth is no longer, some kid will open a book or some new format of technology years to come, and maybe it'll only be one or two recordings of something, but then they'll see Marcus Printup. They'll see Victor Goines up in there, because there were a lot of great trumpet players and saxophone and clarinet players before he and I respectively, who were not listed in the history of jazz because of lack of documentation. Now that with the technology of 1917 and the first recording by original Dixieland Jazz Band and going forward to today, we are very fortunate to be part of a movement and a legacy that will allow us and many more people to come to be documented in the history of jazz.